Hello. Now, today on my masterclass, we're going political. You know, I'm here to talk about how all those who undermined former President Jonathan, who lied against him, you know, who told a complete falsehood against him to try to undermine him so that they could get to power, how they are all reaping what they sowed, one by one, all of them. And look, I'm telling you, with what I know, some of them are reaping it. People like Amechi, you don't know what is happening publicly yet. It will become public. But I'm going to talk about the ones that are public now. Let's talk about Bola Tinubu. You know, Bola Tinubu is somebody who coined that word, clueless Jonathan. It was Bola Tinubu that coined it. You know, went about with his dirty yellow stained teeth, you know, going about in using, you know, some very uncouth words on the former president. You know, this is a man who did his best for Nigeria. And then Bola Tinubu went about undermining the man, lying against the man, you know, saying all kinds of things. Look at Bola Tinubu. Where is he today? Look at the statement he released yesterday. Oh, you know, what's his eye of fire say? Sophia Pins. I felt sorry for him. But listen to this. Look, Buhari is not done with you. Those bullion vans, you think that is... They will come back to that. Look at Sanusi Lamido Sanusi, the former governor of the central bank. Sanusi Lamido Sanusi is a liar. Sanusi, take me to court. Me, Reno Omokri, this is video. Take me to court. I've called you a liar. I will open the book and I will disgrace you. This is a man who lied that former President Jonathan, that $49.8 billion was missing for the Federation account. A governor of the Central Bank of Nigeria. Then when that was exposed to be a lie, he reduced it to $22 billion. Then to $12 billion, then to $10.8 billion. But because of the way they had bribed the media, people, they were whipping up anti-Jonathan sentiments. All that was a lie. Former President Jonathan has been out of office for 5 years. Where is the accusation? Where is the $10.8 billion? Where is the $22 billion? Where is the $12 billion? Where is the $49.8 billion? It was all lies. And Sanusi knew it was lies when he was saying it. It was part of their plan. They leaked the letter to, Amechi. All this was planned to undermine former President Jonathan, and we are reaping it now in Nigeria. Look at Adams Oshiomhole. In 2013, he won his re-election under former President Jonathan because Jonathan allowed for a free and fair election. Jonathan did not support the PDP candidates. Jonathan said, let there be a level playing ground. He said, my ambition is not worth the blood of any Nigerians. After Oshiomhole won, he came to the villa to thank former President Jonathan. When Jonathan was out of power, he began insulting him with uncouth language, lying that he went to America, and in America, they told him that just three people under Jonathan, that they looted, was it about $30 billion, all kinds of useless manner of lies. Look at him today now. Kicked out by his own party, they say they want to go to court. Does Buhari respect court judgments? Look at Obiezu Ezekwesili. He weaponized Bring Back Our Girls under former President Jonathan. He just went about causing an embarrassment about, you know, rolling on the floor. Look at her today now. Nasir El-Rufai's son publicly came out and disgraced her, called her publicly, begged her with receipts, said that she comes to beg in the night his father for money. Can you imagine that? Look at Omoyele Sowore. Omoyele Sowore, a blackmailer, a liar, used his Sahara reporters to undermine former President Jonathan with different lies. You can Google it. I chronicled 15 lies that the young man told against former President Jonathan. On the day that Muhammadu Buhari won, Omoyele Sowore celebrated. I released the video on YouTube. Celebrated. He was happy. He was almost shedding tears. And he says he wants to be president of Nigeria. God forbid. You're such a useless blackmailer. Yes, I said it. Take me to court. I am a patriot. I feel so bad because of what is happening in my country. I'm not going to start pretending. I don't want to contest for any election. I am here to say the truth. Look at Ango Abdullahi of Northern Elders Forum. When he was insulting former President Jonathan, did Jonathan say anything against him? Did Jonathan release statements insulting him? He tried that under Buhari. What has happened? Yes, 3 days ago, the presidency released a statement insulting him. Now, they cannot go to their villages. Headsmen, bandits, kidnappers, Boko Haram. Completely, the entire North is completely insecure. Worse than what it was under Jonathan. Now, Nigeria, according to the Global Terrorism Index, is the third most terrorized country in the world. We are more insecure than Syria, where they are fighting war. Look at Rabbi Musa Kwankwaso in Kano, saying that they used our Almajiri to get rid of Jonathan. Look at now, the Almajiri, they are now kicking them out of Kano. They say they are bringing COVID-19. The only man to have built a school for them was Jonathan. Yeah, they were stoning Jonathan. They stoned him in Bauchi. They stoned him in Katsina. Built hundreds of schools for them. And then look at what they did to him. The 9 universities in northern Nigeria, Jonathan built it. Look at how they treated him. Look at Wole Soyinka. Not only did he insult former President Jonathan, the first lady, the impeachment Jonathan, called her a hippopotamus. He asked Nigerians to forgive Buhari. Today, he cannot even talk. Aisha Buhari has turned the presidential villa into a shooting range. She goes about quarreling, such a quarrelsome woman. The presidential villa is now a place of domestic disputes. Where is Wole Soyinka? Can he talk? 2 months ago, the presidency released a statement ridiculing, insulting him. I felt like crying, Wole Soyinka. Look at how you have reduced yourself from Nobel award. Now you are not even a noble man. Just look at that. You see, Wole Soyinka should accept responsibility for bringing the worst ruler in Nigeria's history. Look at it. Farouk Perobi just wrote a statement of the amount of corruption under Buhari. According to Farouk Perogi, this is not me. And remember, Farouk Perogi is a former Buhari loyalist. They said that the amount of corruption that Tunde Sabiu, that is Buhari's nephew who he has made his special assistant or his private secretary. Can you imagine? That is corruption because that is nepotism. He said that the man has almost $1 trillion in his account. I am quoting Farouk Perogi. And he says that even the CBN governor is aware of it. I am quoting Farouk Perogi. Look at, on that, according to Transparency International, Nigeria is more corrupt right now than at any time under former President Jonathan. Who owns the Ikoyi apartment billion? Still today, they've not told you. If it was former President Jonathan or anybody under his government, it would have taken 2 seconds for them to tell you. Look at that now. Look at where Aisha Buhari's ADC that looted so much money. What has happened to him? Where is Babaji Lawal? Are they trying him? Just imagine that. Look at the kind of corruption under this administration. When Buhari goes and a good government comes, when they expose Buhari, oh, Nigerians will weep. And Wole Soyinka, I am so ashamed of you. You were alive in 1983 to 1985 when this man ruined Nigeria. You, as a lecturer and your colleagues, you were running out of Nigeria, going abroad, and you came back and you began to promote this man simply because you hated Jonathan. You said anything but Jonathan because he's a minority. Look at it now. Can you talk? Can you cough? No, I'm asking you, can you talk? Can you cough? You can't. And it is so sad what is happening in Nigeria now under Muhammadu Buhari. Look, Jonathan was using the army to try to cage these headsmen so that they don't kill Nigerians. El Rufai said that if he tries that, insulting him. Look at what's happening in Nigeria now. Headsmen are killing. Aodu Ogbe, who was the man who was holding a rally, they were attacking Jonathan, undermining Jonathan. Aodu Ogbe cannot even go to his own village in Benue because of headsmen, because of insecurity. It is not coincidental. All these things are spiritual. I know former President Jonathan. He spent 10 days with me and my family in California. The man, the man can't hurt a fly. This man, he is not a perfect man. Nobody's perfect, but he is the most selfless leader ever to have governed Nigeria. A man who cannot hurt a fly, look at Almajiri. He built over 100 schools for them. Is he a Muslim? Is he a northerner? Buhari, who is a Muslim and who is a northerner, how many schools has he built for Amajiri? How many? Jonathan built 9 universities in northern Nigeria, only 3 in the south. This was a man who did not... Look at him now. Buhari, Chief of Army Staff, National Security Advisor, Chief of Minister of Defense, Chief of Air Force, Head of the Police, Head of EFCC, Head of DMI, Head of MPS, Customs, Immigration, all northern Muslim males. Is Nigeria a Muslim brotherhood? Under former President Jonathan, these things was balanced. In the military, 55% of the headship went to northern Muslims, and then only 45 went to Christian southerners. Look at that. There was balance. Today, is there balance? Under Jonathan, Nigeria was the 3rd fastest growing economy in the world. Today, we are the world headquarters for extreme poverty. Look at that. General Buhari said former President Jonathan ruined Nigeria. Okay, now I'm going to give you facts and figures. And everything I'm saying, don't forget, I deal in facts. You can go and research it. I only deal in facts. I am a child of God. I will not come here to lie to you. 50 kilogram bag of rice under Jonathan was 8,000 naira. How much is it today? We fuel under Jonathan 87 naira per liter. $1 was equivalent to 150 naira. A Lagos to Abuja airfare was 10,000 naira. A bottle of Coke was 60 naira. A tin of pig milk was 80 naira. In 2011, Gallup polls rated Nigeria under former President Jonathan as the happiest place on earth. The happiest place on earth, bar none. Today, Nigeria is facing a suicide crisis. General Muhammadu Buhari said he saved Nigeria from collapse. Yet, Nigeria is now the world headquarters for extreme poverty. According to the World Bank, our economy is going to witness the worst recession ever in our history. I'm asking you, Nigerians, think about what you did to this man. Is the man paying me? No. But I have fear of God. What that man, what Nigeria did to that man, oh, that nation needs to beg God for forgiveness. Now, I've said, poured out my heart to you. If it's left for you to take what I said and then ponder it, God bless you.